I wanted out, but you kept pulling me back in. Okay, I've made so many videos about Captain Marvel and my rather tepid opinion on the controversy, but I've got a ton of messages from people asking me to do a video about this, so I said, okay. Rotten Tomatoes has removed its want-to-see rating because of trolls. Now, that's according to, this is Gizmodo, IO9, and the reality is, they're wrong. What is the leftist digital media doing? Trying to wiggle their fingers in the air and claim victory in an issue in which they didn't actually have a victory. Yes, a change was made. But the change was made not just because a lot of people were perceivably trolling, which I don't think they were, but some of them probably were. The change was also made because of left-wing media misrepresenting what was actually happening. As I and many other people have pointed out, particularly The Quartering, no, there was no review bombing. There's a feature on Rotten Tomatoes, okay? Well, there used to be a feature, and it would say, want to see it, and a percentage. They have removed what looks like 10,000 people, but the number, or more. Okay, here's what you do. You would click this, it's changed now, and you would say, I'm not interested in seeing this, or I want to see it, and you could comment on why. It was not a review of the movie, it was kind of a review on the marketing for the movie. Rotten Tomatoes has removed this for a couple reasons. Now, if you only read BuzzFeed, Vox, Jezebel, whatever, you're probably going to believe it was removed because, oh, the trolls, they're getting rid of the trolls. Not true. Let's look at what IO9 says. Yesterday in a blog post, Rotten Tomatoes announced that it's moving forward with a number of steps to more accurately and authentically represent the voice of fans and reduce the influence of bad actors. They then choose this quote, "We are disabling the comment function prior to a movie's release date. Unfortunately, we have seen an uptick in non-constructive input, sometimes bordering on trolling, which we believe is a disservice to our general readership. We've decided that turning off this feature for now is the best course of action. Don't worry, though. Fans will still get to have their say once a movie is released. Audiences can leave a user rating and comments as they always have." Rotten Tomatoes is also removing the want-to-see ratings on movies' pages before they're in theaters, saying people often incorrectly assume that percentage is the same thing as ratings from people who've actually seen the film. Now, I will give it to IO9 for getting that point correct. I have seen, firstly, tons of news articles, I shouldn't even call them news, from various media where they're like, they're review bombing the movie. No, they're not review bombing the movie. This story says, Rotten Tomatoes is changing its audience rating system because of trolls. Right. The point I want to make is that headline is wrong. They are not changing its audience rating system because of trolls. That's not the case. They are changing their want to see it rating because people don't understand the difference between wanting to see a movie and not liking it after the fact. And by people, I mean literally these websites that keep claiming there was a review bomb going on. First of all, can I point out, simply because people have an opinion and comment their opinion on a page for something that is contentious doesn't mean they're trolling or review bombing. My God, did it ever occur to any of these people, Rotten Tomatoes included, that people might just really hate the marketing for Captain Marvel? I know I do. Every single trailer that comes out for the movie, it says her and then an A and an O appear, a hero. And it's like, dude, I get it. I went to Dave & Buster's the other day. Do you know what they have? So there's an escalator to the second floor of this big, like, shopping center. There's a Dave & Buster's, which is like an arcade, if you for those that aren't familiar. And they have this big cardboard, you know, promo thing. It's not a cutout. And it's got Captain Marvel flying above the Earth. And guess what is sitting atop? A little cat. And I'm like, dude, this is part of what makes me want to sit this one out. The weird cat references from all of the pre-screen reviews, the cat action figure, like, dude, I get it. You know, if you want to have like a chick with a cat who fights crime, I have no problem with cats. I'm just going to point out that when the marketing, like one of the commercials, one of the trailers, it goes, you'll never, this is not a game for little girls. Like someone says it in the background. And I'm like, I get where you're going. Okay. By all means, do it. You've got Brie Larson saying it's her big feminist film for sure. Proud of you, girl. Like, do your thing. I'm not really interested in that. Like, that doesn't market to me. I'm not interested in seeing the film because I don't want to see a film about a woman overcoming the boys and, like, showing these boys how we do it, as one of the lines in the trailer. And the cat stuff. I'm just kind of like, dude, I think you maybe made this for, like, a single woman who, you know, is standing up to the boys and owns a cat. That's not me, right? I just like general themes, okay? Don't care if the hero is male or female. I thought Katniss Everdeen for Hunger Games. I love the Hunger Games series. I actually just sat through it all like last month, like a couple weeks ago, watched all the movies one day because they were like, it was a marathon. Fantastic. I think the Hunger Games is fantastic. Katniss Everdeen wasn't trying to prove she was better than the boys. Why? So listen, the point, look, there's a lot of people acting like there's never been a female superhero. That's part of the marketing. Don't get it. Not true. But anyway, I'm sidetracking here. Let's take a look at Rotten Tomatoes. What they say is, over the past 18 months, we made a number of updates at Rotten Tomatoes, all in an effort to streamline the site and provide users with a more enriched experience. These updates include the launch of a new visual identity. You don't hate the red anymore, right? The creation of new original editorial video and social content. Check us out. Blah, blah, blah. We're proud of what we accomplished, but let's get to what you really want to hear about. Starting this week, Rotten Tomatoes will launch the first of several phases of updates that will refresh and modernize our audience rating system. We're doing it to more accurately and authentically represent the voice of fans while protecting our data and public forums from bad actors. They say the want to see percentage is changing because it is often confused with audience score. Was it the trolls who were confusing it? No, it was typically leftist digital media that was confusing it. The individuals who were rating on it knew exactly what they were doing. They were saying, I don't want to see this movie. Here's why. But you see all these digital websites trying to claim it's not the case. What you will now see at the top of a movie or TV page once it's been released is this. Let me clarify. For a lot of people who are talking about this, I'm seeing posts across social media where they said Rotten Tomatoes is defending Captain Marvel. They are intervening to silence the critics. I don't think that's actually fair. I don't. What I think is actually happening is I'd be willing to bet that someone at Rotten Tomatoes is as frustrated as you are when they're like, dude, no, that's not what's happening. What can Rotten Tomatoes do when all of these leftist digital sites claim review bombing is happening? And then they say, oh, people are using Rotten Tomatoes to smear the movie. What can Rotten Tomatoes do? Can they call up and get these articles changed? No, they can say, you know what? Too many people are confusing this, so we're going to just change it and get rid of it. I don't think this is necessarily a dig at the critics, like the audience members who are saying, I don't want to see this. I think it's a dig more at digital media. Now, look, would it be fair to say that Rotten Tomatoes only is critical of the digital media? No, of course. And I'm sure Rotten Tomatoes is saying they've said some people are taking advantage of this system, but based on the changes they've made, I really think this is more about leftists in media who want to frame a narrative and they're purposefully misconstruing what's actually happening to push their narrative. This idea that trolls are showing up to review bomb the movie never happened. Why? Because you can't review a movie that's not out yet. And Rotten Tomatoes wanted to have a system where you could say if you wanted to see it or not. They've now gotten rid of that because of how it was being misrepresented by press, not because of the trolling. They do, apparently they do make reference to trolling, I guess. I don't even see that in their editorial. So look, Rotten Tomatoes publishes this comment. What do they say? Yesterday in a blog post. Yeah, that's what I opened. I thought that's what I opened. Where does it reference trolling? Bordering on trolling? There we talk about this. What else are we doing? Oh, okay, so here it is. They say, what else are we doing? We are disabling the comment function prior to a movie's release date. Unfortunately, we have seen an uptick in non-constructive input, sometimes bordering on trolling, which we believe is a disservice. Okay, so I read that. So let me read the last paragraph. Last but not least, you will notice we are making some layout changes to the site. Through our research department, we have learned that our users would prefer a cleaner, less cluttered presentation of the tomato meter and audience score. Sure, whatever. I have no problem with Rotten Tomatoes. I have a problem with the Twitterati far-left digital media sphere that lies. And you can see this reflected in movies that suck getting good ratings, i.e. Last Jedi, and movies that are actually really enjoyable that get bad ratings, Death Wish. So I've actually made several videos talking about how, like, Death Wish, for instance, for those that aren't familiar, it's a movie about a guy whose family gets killed, and then he goes and gets an act of revenge. It's like a traditional revenge samurai film, but in a modern take. And the reviews were miserable from critics, but the audience score loved it. The reason the critics hated it? One guy called it a gun nut masturbation fantasy. And I'm like, dude, art from the artist, please. Right? The movie didn't market a guy as like a gun nut with a ton of guns. Like it was a movie about a dad whose family was, his wife was killed. I think that's what it was. Now, something different here is they do market Captain Marvel as a big feminist film. And the audience doesn't like it. So you look at The Last Jedi, And there was so much wrong with that movie. It was just god-awful, and everyone knows it. And it's got a miserable audience score, but the critics love it. That's the problem with Rotten Tomatoes. It's useless, for the most part. You have to avoid high-profile movies. But I want to point one more thing out before I wrap up here. If you were to read this from top down, I like how they call Rotten Tomatoes RT, because people are going to confuse it with, like, Russia Today. But if you start, they flat out say people are confusing the score. What does IO9 do? They invert it, so it's actually about getting rid of the trolls. No, IO9, you're part of the problem. Not the people who are commenting about how they feel based on a movie's marketing. You are the one who misconstrues what's actually going on. And I don't want to accuse them specifically of confusing the number, but this is what they were all doing. They were all claiming it was a review bomb, and I had to say, like, in 5 videos, it's not a review bomb, and just because people are critical doesn't mean they're trolls. You know what? I'm done. I didn't even want to talk about Captain Marvel again in the first place, but I got so many messages. Seriously, I got, like, several dozen messages from people saying, talk about this, bring this up, this is huge. And there's my opinion, which kind of flies in the face of what a lot of you actually think. I don't think Rotten Tomatoes is acting to defend Captain Marvel. I think they're actually acting in response to the media misrepresenting them and the people reviewing the movie. So, I'm sorry. There, I did it. People posting whether or not they wanted to see it. Anyway, I'm done. Stick around. I got more videos coming up in a few minutes.